Welcome to BVS Pragati channel. In this session, let's have a look at wave propagation. In the earlier session, as part of wave propagation, we have seen about surface wave or ground wave propagation, sky wave propagation, and we have just started discussing about space wave propagation. So in this session, let's have a look at space wave propagation, and apart from that, we'll also discuss about troposcatter propagation and other terminology related to wave propagation. Space waves. Space waves are frequencies which are above high frequency. So they have very low wavelength. They travel in straight lines. And since they travel in straight lines, they depend on line of sight condition. So space waves are limited in their propagation by the curvature of Earth. Radio horizon. The radio horizon for space wave is about 4/3 as far as the optical horizon. This beneficial effect is due to the varying density of the atmosphere and because of diffraction around the curvature of Earth. So the radio horizon of an antenna is given by dt is the distance from the transmitting antenna where the signal is received. Okay, dt is equal to 4 root ht. So ht is height of transmitting antenna above ground. So the more the height of the transmitting antenna, the more distance the signal can reach. The same formula naturally applies to the receiving antenna. Thus, the total distance will be given by d is equal to dt plus dr, where d is equal to 4 root ht plus 4 root hr. So, the distance to which signal communication happens is dependent on the height of transmitting antenna and height of receiving antenna. So, the more the transmitting antenna height and more the receiving antenna height, the more distance you can transmit the signal. For a transmitting antenna of height 225 meters above ground level, the radio horizon is 60 kilometers. If receiving antenna is 16 meters above ground level, so total distance can be increased to 76 kilometers. How? 4 root ht plus 4 root hr. So 4 into 4 is 16 over here. HD is 225, so root of 225 is 15, 4 into 15 is 60 kilometers. So, as you increase the receiving antenna height, the total distance can be increased to 76 kilometers. So, this is how the signal gets transmitted. Troposcatter propagation. So, in troposcatter propagation, you transmit signals which are above 1000 megahertz and they are transmitted at a distance of about 15 kilometers from ground. Duct propagation. In normal atmosphere, as temperature increases, what happens? Air density decreases, refractive index decreases. But at sea source, what happens near the sea shores, what happens due to warm air, the temperature increases with height and also the refractive index increases. So this region is called inversion layer and this is very useful for microwave communication. Now let's have a look at the terminology related to wave propagation. Gyro frequency. Gyro frequency is 1400 kilohertz. At this frequency, cyclotron effect occurs and the frequency is not reflected back as electrons are getting deflected because of Earth's magnetic field. So the rays are lost. SIT. SIT is sudden ionospheric disturbances occur once in 11 years. This is called solar cycle or sunspot cycle. At this time, what happens? Ionization is more in D layer. And what happens? It absorbs medium frequencies and slow wave signals. This is called SID. About 12 gigahertz, signal cannot be propagated with troposphere method without repeaters. Primary coverage area. Signals that can be received without an attenuation is primary coverage area. Secondary coverage area is that area where signals are received with some loss. Window. At certain frequencies, absorption by atmosphere is very less. These frequencies are called windows. So that's all about wave propagation. More in the next session. Thank you. Thanks a lot and I wish you all the best.